on this episode of Tropical Fish Store Tours.
I'm at Tropical Imports in Glendale, California.
I'm Jacob Castro, otherwise known as Jacob's Aquarium on YouTube. I'm a planet tank geek that loves the aquarium hobby, and I'm on a mission to find America's greatest tropical fish stores. With so many to choose from, and online reviews being as unreliable as they are, you can count on me to show you the best stores with the most to offer. Welcome to another episode of Tropical Fish Store Tours, here on Jacob's Aquarium.
Hi, my name's Kurt. I've worked here at Tropical Imports for roughly about 15 years. I pretty much manage the storefront and make sure everything is as clean as possible and make sure that customers are taken care of as best as possible. Make sure they're given the right information so that they're get their aquarium home and they're very happy with what they have. We want to make sure that they know that they're going to be able to take care of their fish or their reptiles properly, because we don't want anybody to, one, waste their money, or two, have the animals hurt, or worse, have them pass away. I've been here for about 15 years, but the store's been open for a little bit over 40 years.
Wow.
The original owner was actually a family friend, and my brother, who's now the current owner, started working here roughly about maybe between 22, 23 years ago.
Oh my gosh.
And then he eventually purchased it from the original owner about 16 years ago when the owner was ready to retire. So it's been owned by my family for about 16 years.
That's really cool. So you guys have a lot of history here in Glendale because the store's been here for a while. How exciting was that for, you know, your brother just to be an employee here, and then now he owns his own tropical fish store? That must have been like a dream come true, right?
You know, I mean, I've never asked him what his actual thoughts on it were, but as for me, when I first started working here, I started working here because I was in high school and I needed a job. I wasn't a huge fish person. I was more into reptiles. I had some snakes, some bearded dragons. That's what I was into at the time. After I started working here, I started to appreciate fish for a lot more than how I used to. So I've gotten a lot more into the hobby than before I started. So I don't know if it was the same for him, if he got more into it after he started working here, or beforehand. But for me, I've gotten really into the hobby, and if things work out, I would like to actually open up my own store if the things permit.
Oh, nice. So do you have a fish tank at home?
Yes, right now I have a 120 gallon. It's a freshwater Planet Aquarium.
Oh, well, all my followers are really big into Planet Aquariums too. What kind of plants do you got?
Right now, not a whole lot at the moment. I haven't been able to stay up on the maintenance as I usually would like to.
Yeah.
So I've been making sure that I've been keeping my filters clean so that the fish would stay healthy. As far as plants, there's a few different types of crypts in there. The ones I'm really happy, I've two different types of kind of rare onion plants.
Oh, cool.
There's I don't know the scientific name on them, but when you think of your standard aquarium onion plant, where they have the real long skinny leaves,
yeah.
Or they're one is pretty narrow, but it actually spirals.
Oh, that's
so it looks similar to like a corkscrew valcinaria.
Right.
And then the other one has more of a crinkled leaf, almost looks like a leaf similar to like a Pongagetan ulvaceus. However, the leaves are a little bit thinner and darker.
That's really cool. It sounds like a beautiful tank.
Well, they're really good because it's a 120 gallon tank. It's 2 feet tall. The leaves actually go up all the way to the top and then come down almost halfway. So the leaves are probably about 3 feet tall.
Wow. So it pretty much just looks like a big jungle tank, huh? Lots of plants.
Pretty much. That's big pieces of wood, little shrimp cruising around, and little tetras swimming out and behind them.
That's really cool. Okay, so I know you guys service tanks, so tell me about the whole service part of the company.
Well, we have a lot of homes and businesses where people either don't feel comfortable maintaining the aquarium if it's in a home, or they don't have the time, or a lot of times it's an office, somebody that maybe a lawyer or a restaurant where
they're too busy.
Yeah, they're too busy to do it, and they don't have anybody there that's qualified to do it. So we offer home and maintenance installation and servicing. So a lot of homes, we tend to go about once a month, where a lot of businesses tend to be twice a month, where we'll go and do a good thorough cleaning at the beginning of the month. Halfway through, we'll go and do a touch-up, clean the glass, clean the plants, move things around, you know, so it looks nice and clean. So nobody walks into the office and sees a dirty fish tank sitting there.
Exactly. So do you notice that more service accounts are saltwater or more freshwater? Which one seems to be the most popular?
Well, for businesses, it's about 50-50. Just because of the initial startup to do a saltwater tank properly, it is more expensive. And I've had multiple accounts that have freshwater tanks that wanted saltwater, but when I showed them what was going to be required to maintain that, they didn't want to invest that much money into it.
Right.
So I would say it's about 50-50 on the aspect for businesses. For homes, it tends to be more saltwater, just for the people that don't feel they have the time to pay the attention to it that it requires.
Right, because with saltwater tanks, you need special water, you need special things for the fish, right? It's just a little bit more higher maintenance.
Yeah, a little bit more work. It's not a lot more work, but it's that attention to detail that most people feel they don't have the time for.
Right. Okay, so how about the range of the service company? How far will you guys go to service a tank?
Well, we don't have any set limits. It just kind of depends on, I guess, the aquarium size. If it's just an hour job, if it's going to take us, you know, 20, 30 minutes to get there, if that's non-traffic time, then that would be fine. You know, we would make that distance if it helped made the customer happy. We're here in Glendale, where we went all the way out to the city of industry for Morehouse Mustards, which used to have a 300-gallon tank in their office.
Oh, wow. Okay, so are there like any large, unique, extravagant tanks that you guys service, or are they pretty much just like the standard, say, 50, 100-gallon?
You know, there's a lot of different sizes. We have an escrow company that has a 180-gallon, I believe it is.
Wow, that's a big tank.
And then there's Damon's Restaurant, which has, I believe it's a 240. So those are both large saltwater tanks.
Yeah. Is it pretty hard to maintain like a larger tank, or is it easier than a smaller tank? Because like I've heard that larger saltwater tanks tend to be more stable. So is that pretty much the case with big tanks?
Yeah, because there's more water to absorb any changes in the water quality.
Oh, okay.
So if something, if a fish, say, doesn't make it, or you lose a hermit crab or a snail, if a snail dies in a 10-gallon tank, that can pollute the water pretty quickly. Where if it's in a 120-gallon tank, you know, it'll probably go unnoticed.
Right.
So larger tanks do have more of a balance, as long as, once again, the maintenance is stayed up on. Where I know a lot of people that when I recommend a monthly water change, they'll tell me that in the past they've had an aquarium where they didn't change the water for 6 months and never had a problem. And yeah, I've heard plenty of cases where people have gotten away with it, but the problem is there's so much stuff that builds up in the water, things that we can't test for. So when will you hit that breaking point of everything seems fine versus your fish are all belly up in the morning?
Right, because not every issue that could happen in a tank is visible, right?
Right, there's a lot of things that are in the water that you can't see. Some you can test for, some you can't. Salinity is your most common issue. People don't pay close enough attention to that. Water evaporates, salt doesn't. So if you keep topping off with salt water, eventually the salt gets so high that it starts to hurt your pets.
Exactly. Completely agree. Okay, so here at the store, about how many holding tanks would you guys say that you have?
Oh, man, there's about 30 in the saltwater room where we're at right now.
Oh, wow.
And then as far as our freshwater, I don't remember the exact count, but I mean, we're easily past 60.
Oh my gosh, that's a lot of tanks. Is it hard like maintaining that many tanks in a fish store, or is it pretty simple? Because like I know you guys use some system filtration, so does that make it a little easier for having a bunch of tanks in one store?
Well, as far as just maintaining the water levels, yes, that makes it easy. However, that doesn't help us out with keeping the environment on the inside clean, cleaning algae off the glass, keeping the decorations clean. I mean, we're pretty much cleaning aquariums every day.
Wow.
So there's one person that works with us almost full-time just cleaning tanks.
And cleaning tanks, that's all his?
That's all he does.
Wow.
And he doesn't get it all done alone. I was cleaning tanks yesterday. I was cleaning tanks before you got in here today. So it's a nonstop thing.
That's cool. That sounds like a pretty pretty hefty job, huh?
Just cleaning tanks,
and you have to stay on top of all the parameters and.
Yeah, it's a lot to do, but if you enjoy it, it's not bad.
Exactly. If you have a passion for it, it's like it's just another day.
Exactly.
Yeah, completely agree.
Okay, so tell us about the different types of fish and invertebrates you guys have. Do you guys have pretty wide selection of different fish, saltwater and freshwater?
You know, I feel we have a really good selection. However, when anybody comes in and takes a look around, I get, you know, comments on both ends. Some people say we don't have very much. Yeah. Some people say we have a lot more than other places. And I think it just kind of depends on what you're looking for. You know, if you come in here on a weekly basis, you'll see a lot of the same fish here.
Right.
Sometimes you'll see some different ones. But the reason we stick with a lot of the same fish is they're fish that are two things. One, relatively inexpensive for what they are. And next, they're known for having a very good track record. They're a very hardy fish.
Right. That's important.
It is. I mean, one, I don't want the fish to die on you, and I don't want it to die on me either. There's a lot of fish that are pretty much known that they're not going to do well right off the bat. So you'll never see one of those fish in here because there's no point. Beyond that, there's fish that are hardy, but they're just really expensive. It's not every day that somebody's going to want a $400 or $500 fish.
Exactly, yeah.
So with something like that, there's a lot of fish that are available, but we usually only bring those in on special order.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, I completely agree because it's like it makes no sense to bring in a bunch of really exotic fish because, as you said, nobody's going to come in and buy, you know, that fish every week. So it makes more sense to just keep stuff that's, you know, more typical, easy to keep, you know, so possibly people that are beginners, they have an easier time getting into the hobby, right?
Well, yeah. I don't want to sell somebody a fish that I know is going to go belly up. Then when that happens, they're unhappy. Then they decide to tear down their tank because they couldn't keep it alive. Then they tell their friends not to do salt water because it was too hard.
That's not good.
And I want to make sure that they're happy with their tank because that's how we're going to get more business. They're going to tell their friends that I helped them get their tank set up. They're happy with it. And their friends should have a tank too.
Exactly.
Yeah, you definitely want to give a good review because you want to get more people into the hobby. It's a tremendously fun hobby.
It's very fun. There's a lot of work involved, and if you get into it, you're going to love it. And as far as the fish goes, you know, there's going to be different tastes on different aspects, but it all comes back to making sure the customers are happy and they're keeping their tank healthy so they're enjoying it. If they're not enjoying it, that's not going to be good for us. And like I said, we've been here for over 40 years. That hasn't happened by, you know, selling the wrong products.
Okay, so a lot of people ask me when I do these store tours, the biggest question is, where do these stores get their fish? Because they want to know, you know, what sources you're getting the fish from, and so they can, like, determine, I guess, potential health issues and stuff like that. Like, I guess quality, you could say. So where do you guys acquire most of your fresh and saltwater fish? I know there's a couple pretty big wholesalers in L.A., sea-dwelling creatures. Do you work with them?
We do on occasion. We have a few places that we work from. It just depends. Just like us, we may not have the same fish next week as what we do this week. They're the same. So sometimes we'll go into one place and they'll have something and the other place won't. It really varies. As far as most of our salt water, yes, it would come from, could be All Seas Marine, Underwater Depot, or then sea-dwelling creatures. Most of our fresh water comes from other suppliers.
Okay.
All right, and then last question. Another big question people ask me all the time. Tell me about the filtration systems you guys utilize for the holding tanks. Are they all pretty much just the same? Like, are they all system filtrations, or are they individual systems? Or?
Well, as far as our saltwater room goes, we have our live rock bin and our cubicles for inverts, which is one system together. Then we have two different reef tanks in here. We have one that's an 85 that's set up a standalone. Then there's two that are right above each other, which are all one system.
Oh.
As far as our main tanks, which are along the wall, all those tanks are all linked together to a big sump, which is behind the store.
Okay.
All right, really cool. Well, thank you for telling me about the store. I really appreciate it. Now we're going to take you guys on a tour of the store and show you what the store has to offer. So thanks again, Kurt.
All right, you're welcome. Thank you.
All right, guys. Now it's time to do the tour and show you guys Tropical Imports here in Glendale. So let's head on over here, and I'm going to show you guys the goldfish that they have. They have a pretty good selection of, you know, pretty much any different types of goldfish. They actually have ranchus, which are pretty popular, pretty requested on my YouTube channel. I've seen they have Orandas over here, Ryukins, assorted Orandas, and then some assorted koi at the bottom. So if you're starting a pond, or if you like goldfish, you're doing a goldfish tank, they have plenty of different types of goldfish here. Over here, you'll see they have some turtles too as well. Some red slider turtles and African side neck, I believe they're called. That's pretty cool. So if you wanted to do a turtle tank, they have some turtles here. Pretty cool looking guys. Over here, you'll see they have some plants as well. Pretty good selection of plants. I would say pretty much just like the basic. We got some swords here. A nice big crypt in the back. That's actually a big crypt. That's probably taken a long time to get to that size. So I would buy that, but I don't have any room in my tanks. So we got some jungle val. Lots of jungle val in here. So a lot of people like jungle val. So if you're looking for that, they have that here too. As I said, swords, and down here, some more plants. Ananarchus, fast-growing plant, easy-to-grow plant. More Ananarchus up here. And then just some more, I'm not sure the name of this plant, but it looks like some type of Indian leaf plant. And then they got some potted plants over here. They got some crypts and cardinal plants and stuff. So, and then it looks like some hair grass in the back. So, pretty good selection of plants. I would say good for somebody just starting out in the hobby, looking for some easy to grow starter plants, nothing too intricate yet. So let's go ahead and move on down and check out the aisles of fish. Let's take a look at the fish that they got. They got some, I'm not sure the names. There's so many different types of fish, guys. It's so hard to know the names of these fish. But they actually got a gold nugget pleco in the corner right here. It's pretty interesting. Down here, they got some more more fish. Sorry, I'm having a hard time with the names here. Goldfish at the bottom as well. As we move down, we kind of get into, I would say, community fish. So guppies up here, pretty cool, lots of different colors. Some puffers up here, these little baby puffers, these are pretty cool. And then as we move down, we got some barbs, lots of colorful fish. That's what I've noticed here at Tropical Imports. If you like a tank with a lot of color, there's lots of colorful fish here to choose from. Down here, some more barbs as well. Goldfish at the bottom. It's just tanks everywhere. So many tanks. It's like tanks from floor to the ceiling, taller than me. It's pretty crazy. So as we move on down, we got some hyphen. Not sure, but hyphen fish. I'll just say that. But I'm sure you guys that are into you guys out there that are big fish geeks, you'll know all the names of these fish better than I do. Really cool fish. It seems like they got a good selection of regular fish and then some unique fish as well, because some of the ones that I'm seeing I have never seen before. So pretty cool. So got some interesting fish up there, some more here. Lots of plecos down here. Pretty much just the common plecos, I would say. That's pretty interesting. And then some beautiful tetras right here. These go really good with Planet tanks. It's kind of like the neon tetras. They got that orange fluorescent stripe going through their bodies. I think that's always cool. Add some color to the tank. They got some black swords up here, I guess they're called. These are pretty cool. Not the best for planet tanks because they tend to be a little nippy. So I would stay away from those. But if you just have a normal tropical community fish tank, that would work well for you, those fish. And then just some more regular community fish down here. So let's keep going down the line. They got some angelfish up here, some koi angels. Beautiful, look at that. Oh my gosh, I love angelfish. I can't get over them, man. These angelfish go really great with planet tanks because they're just so graceful. And when they get really large, and especially if you have a large tank and you grow them to their full adult size, they just look fantastic in a planet tank. So beautiful koi angel fish. They look pretty small, so they still got some time to grow. So if you're one of those people that like to buy fish and watch them grow, raise them from babies, well, they got some small fish here, so you can definitely go on that journey if buying some of these angels from Tropical Imports. At the bottom tank, some more goldfish down there. Just lots and lots of tanks. I can't get over it. It's like floor to ceiling. So many different tanks to choose from. I got some more black tetras, I'm guessing, down here. Black tetra fish and some mollies with those big bellies. Those are pretty cool. And then up here we got, oh my gosh, look at this big guy. A female red tear, $129. Oh my gosh. Definitely worth it though, because look at this. She's beautiful. If you're one of those, and I see she's kind of made a little nest for herself too. cichlids have a tendency of doing that, of moving gravel around, and I'm pretty sure they do that in the wild too, like in their natural habitat of Lake Malawi, you know, in Africa. I believe it's just, you know, they're building their home, or they could be building a place where they're going to breed. I'm not entirely sure why they do that, but probably either one of those things. But nonetheless, they do make quite a mess in your aquarium. I'm sure most of you guys have experienced that. But beautiful fish. And this is something I like to focus on in particular when I come to tropical fish stores to do tours, is that I wanted to focus on fish that are kind of, you know, kind of specialty fish, you know, fish that aren't like the average, you know, community fish that you see. So this fish has obviously had some time to grow. It's an adult fish, and it's definitely, it would make a beautiful addition to a large aquarium for sure. Red terrors are territorial, so that's something else to consider. But in my opinion, $129 for a fish of this size and color, it's just a beautiful fish, is definitely worth it. I would say that's a discounted price. So awesome deals here at Tropical Imports. So as we move down, we got some more fish down here. I'm not really sure. I think these are called some type of, yeah, glowfish, actually. That's what they're called, glowfish. And I don't think that they inject dye into these fish to turn that color. I believe it's just something they do scientifically to get them to that color. Because I know people have a lot of, or they consider it cruel to dye fish different colors. But I'm pretty sure that there's some type of scientific way that they get these fish to turn this color, as far as I've heard. Because I've heard glowfish is are not dyed fish, but they're more of like a designer fish. So they've been specifically bred and engineered to be that color. So up here, some more veil tail angelfish, pretty cool. They're pretty small as well, so if you like raising small fish, got some more small angels there. These guys are really cool. I'm sure you guys you can recognize these guys. These are zebra Daniels. I had these in my planet tank for years, and they're great fish. They're a little nippy with some plants, but I would say with more broadleaf plants, like you know, plants that aren't too sensitive, they go well with those type of plants, and they really can't tear them apart. They're really fast swimmers. They look really, really cool when they school together in a school. I think they look really cool. And up here we got some needlenose gars. These fish are, I mean, they're pretty badass. I love watching them eat. These guys, I've seen them at Petco before years ago when I was a kid, but I watched one of the employees feed these fish one time, and these fish will take a whole feeder fish and just swallow it whole. And sometimes they actually can't fit the whole thing in their mouth, in their body, so the fish will still hang out of their mouth while while they're already digesting it. But really cool fish. They are aggressive, so not a fish for the community tank, but really interesting fish. And I don't think they get too big either. I think they get maybe 7-8 inches, but not too big like some garfish, you know. So moving down, we got some more kind of catfish down here. Goldfish seem to be lining the entire bottom tanks, so they got lots and lots of goldfish here. So if you're a goldfish lover, definitely come down and check out Tropical Imports. And these fish might seem familiar as well. I've had these fish in my tank before. I actually gave them away to a friend though, because they were pretty nippy with some of my plants. So not the best fish for planet tanks, I would say, but the color, I love the red color. And especially when you have a lot of them, you know, I mean, you can use them in a planet tank with Anubias, you know, plants that are pretty hardy, as I mentioned with the other fish we just talked about. So you can put them in planet tanks, and you know, you just got to make sure that the plants aren't too sensitive. But yeah, the color along with the plants, you know, the color of the plants, it just contrasts so beautifully. So these are really, really awesome fish. And of course, these are Reg Wag Pleiades. The price is $349, or you can get two for $6. Pretty cool. So moving on down, we got a white, or I think they call this an albino lobster or white lobster. I'm not really sure, but pretty cool. As we move down, we got some grammys up here. I believe these are pronounced opaline grammys. I love grammys, guys. They're one of the more bigger fish that you can keep in a planet tank, which is cool because, you know, with a planet tank, usually only small fish seem to work out. But, you know, discus fish and grammys, you know, these are larger fish that you can keep in a planet tank because they aren't too nippy. Of course, I wouldn't keep them with sensitive plants, so still, you know, stick with, you know, hardy plants like Amazon swords, you know, big plants like that. But yeah, you can definitely keep them with plants, and I think they're just really beautiful fish. I love gouramis. I might actually pick up a couple for myself. These are $6.99 at Tropical Imports. I would say that's a great price considering their size, because they are bigger than you know, the average gourami. I would say most gouramis stores get from wholesalers are pretty small. You know, they're pretty small juveniles. But these seem to have had a little bit time to grow, so they're a little bit bigger. So $6.99 definitely justifies that. Down here we got some more tetras, and we got some sharks down here, some bala sharks. Those are really fast swimmers, very active, so if you like an active tank, it'd be good to go with those. I'm not sure if you can have those with the planet tank though. I've never tried that before. Now up here we get to some fish that are really popular with planet tanks, neon tetras, and these guys are really, really tiny, so they got some time to grow. Neon tetras are one of my favorite fish. I have actually neon tetras in my tank at home, and when you have a big school of them, you know, and they have that blue fluorescent stripe going through their bodies, just it looks fantastic, guys. They're just such beautiful fish when they school together, and they go really, really well with planted tanks. So you can get them individually for $1.99 or 3 for $5. So we move down here, and they got some whitefish. Once again, going with the generic names. I'm not too good with the names on all these fish, guys. I'm not a fish geek. I'm more of a plant geek. But I would say they're really beautiful fish nonetheless. And we got some pretty just normal community fish down here. We won't focus too much on those guys. But up here, I think, is a fish you guys are really going to want to see. And something that I actually have kept before as well. Discus fish. Check out these guys. Oh my gosh. And they don't have a lot of them here, and you can understand why. These are very sought after fish. They may be pricey, but you know what? People still buy them. They still invest in them because they are so beautiful, and they go well with planet tanks as well. These fish aren't too nippy. They typically will leave small plants alone. I know I said earlier that I would still stick with big plants with discus fish, but now that I think about it, you know, I had discus fish with a carpet of dwarf baby tears in my tank, and they didn't bother the carpet of dwarf baby tears. So I would say that you can definitely keep discus fish with a planted tank. So they got some really nice colors. They're saying that these are medium discus, so I would say that they look about medium size. So yeah, $35 for these, or $35.99, great price considering that some, you know, most discus, no matter the size, sell for $69, $70 sometimes at other stores. So $34.99 is a great price. You can definitely, you know, get a good school for a pretty reasonable investment. So love discus fish. I'd like to pick up one of those for myself as well, but I don't think they go too well in a holding tank because they are kind of skittish. That's one thing you want to remember with discus fish is that, because I made this mistake of buying discus in a tank that was in a very active area. Discus fish are very skittish, so you pretty much don't want to keep them in an aquarium that's in a living room or a dining room, you know, somewhere where there's going to be a lot of movement, a lot of people walking by all the time. I would say they work best for tanks that are in like your room or your office, you know, somewhere that's not too busy. Nonetheless, they are really beautiful fish. So on this side also, if you can come around here, Dad, show this over here. I haven't really showed you guys this, but they do have a lot of tanks for sale as well. Pretty large tanks, and they're all in the middle of this aisle. So you can see that they got a big tank here for about $600. I think this looks like about 150, or it's 150 gallon tank for $600. I would say that that's a pretty good price, you know, pretty much average. They got some short tanks down there, so a pretty good selection of aquariums. All right, so let's move over here. And this is kind of the back portion of the aisle over here. Once again, tanks all the way from, well, not the floor to the ceiling, but I would say from my waist to the ceiling. So up here, they got a flower horn in here. Flower horns are beautiful fish. There's actually people that have formed clubs centered around flower horns, societies and stuff. So they seem to be a popular fish and something that people really get into and get crazy about, which I don't mind that, you know. Get crazy about fish, you know, get really into it. It's a great hobby. So move down here, we got some tiger. No, they're not tiger barbs. I'm not sure. But really cool fish. These look like aggressive fish. I'm pretty sure they are aggressive, actually. I don't remember the names, but they are aggressive, so not a community fish. Got some cichlids down here with some fake plants, of course. You can't keep cichlids with real plants because, unfortunately, they will tear them apart. Cichlids and driftwood and grow really great together. So good selection of cichlids. I believe these guys are $14.99, so a pretty good price. Up here, we got some blue angels, I believe they're called. So $19.99 for blue angels, or you can get two for $30. So it's a pretty good deal. Beautiful fish. Once again, go great with planted tanks. Over here, it seems like we get into their cichlids over here. So this is the second aisle on the right side of the store when you come in. So this seems to be pretty much a lot of their cichlids on this aisle. So we'll just go start from the top to the bottom. They got some, let's say they got a unique fish over here, $69.99. Not sure what that says, but it looks like a specialty fish, not something you normally see. So if you're into unique cichlids, they got some unique cichlids over here at Tropical Imports. Another unique cichlid in here. Another really big cichlid up here, $39.99, and just a lot of really average, you know, everyday cichlids that you see. Really colorful, you know. If you're one of those people that was considering saltwater but backed off because the cost, you know, saltwater is expensive, you can pretty much do a freshwater tank and still get that color, still get that theme. You know, having a cichlid tank, because there are so many cichlids with that are so many different colors and you know, similar to saltwater fish. So you can still definitely get that effect of having a really colorful fish tank with cichlid fish. So on this aisle, same thing, floor to ceiling tanks, you know, lots to choose from here at Tropical Imports. Cichlids down here. They got a pretty good selection, I would say. Lots of interesting names I'm seeing and interesting colors. So we'll move on down, and they got some more specialty fish. Oh, look at this one. They got a big frontosa. I know these guys. These guys are beautiful as well. And just like with the fish that we talked about earlier, there are people that have formed clubs around this fish because they are so popular and people get into these fish. So $80 for this guy, I would say that's a good price considering how big he is. You know, it's taken a good while to get to that size. So it's a pretty nice fish. So once again, another specialty fish. So you have a lot of unique individual fish like this of many different sizes here at Tropical Imports. So if you're one of those that are looking to make a large investment in your tank with the unique fish, they definitely have them here. So we'll keep on moving down. We can see lots of other unique cichlids. I haven't seen these guys before. These are really pretty. Spotted cichlids or something like that, or they look like zebras to me. So we'll move down and got more cichlids, and again with the goldfish. Lots of goldfish in the bottom tanks, I'm noticing. That seems to be a trend over here in this section of the store. So lots and lots and lots of goldfish. We've got some more cichlids up here. These guys look pretty unique. I've never actually seen these cichlids over here. So these are Elite Blue Jack Dempseys, I believe they're called. So these are $29.99, and you can see the colors are just really, really pretty. So it's kind of unique. I've never seen these cichlids before. So really, really nice colorful fish. More cichlids down here, electric yellows, bumblebees, pretty much assorted cichlids, lots to choose from. Man, if you are going to start a cichlid tank, you could just go crazy in the store. There are so many cichlids to choose from, and you know, prices are pretty good, I would say. You can probably get away with getting a nice, you know, good selection of cichlids for under $100, I would say. So we got some more kind of large cichlids. I guess these are all sold as well, and I can't imagine why. Actually, I can. They're beautiful fish, and you know, fish like these really don't last too long in these stores because you know, finding fish like this of this size, this color, you know, it's pretty much a rare thing. So all these are sold, and really beautiful looking fish. Up here we got some more specialty fish as well. $49.99, $39.99. So kind of pricey, but once again, the uniqueness, the rarity definitely justifies the price. Really, they were just gorgeous. Sometimes I get sidetracked and I forget what I'm doing because I can't stop staring at them. They're so beautiful. I'd love to have a cichlid tank someday. All right, so as we move down, this one's actually really cool too. Look at this guy. Wow, that's really pretty. Beautiful color, $59.99 for that fish. Got another Frontosa over here, $80 for that guy. Seems like he was gonna chop my finger off. really cool. Got some more cichlids from the floor to the ceiling. And then as we move down here to the end of the aisle, just more cichlids as well. So a really big variety of cichlids to choose from here at Tropical Imports. So I would say they have a really good selection of normal freshwater fish as well. So if you're starting a freshwater tank or a cichlid tank, especially a cichlid tank, it seems like cichlids are their focus here. They got tons and tons of cichlids to choose from, so a really good variety. All right, so that's pretty much it for the freshwater section. Now we're going to go ahead and venture over to the saltwater section, where I'm going to show you the selection of saltwater fish that they sell, as well as the filtration system for the saltwater system. So let's go take a look. All right, so now we're in the saltwater section of the store. So I just want to say ahead of time, guys, forgive me if I mispronounce some of the names of the saltwater fish. As you guys know, I'm not too familiar with saltwater. I've never owned a saltwater tank, so I might get some of the names wrong, but nonetheless, I wanted to show you guys. So first we'll start over here. They got this big, beautiful coral tank over here, and lots of different corals to choose from. Like I said, I don't own a saltwater tank, so I wouldn't know if these prices are good or not, but of course you guys can judge by the video. Let me know in the comment section. But really, really beautiful corals, man. Every time I see corals at these tropical fish stores, it makes me want to get into a saltwater tank more and more. They're just so unique, so colorful, just so, so beautiful. You can really do a really awesome saltwater tank here buying corals from Tropical Imports, because it seems like they have a really good selection of corals. So a beautiful coral tank to start with when you get into the saltwater section here at Tropical Imports. Lots of different ones to choose from at all different prices. Okay, so you see on this side they got some more assorted corals and more speciality corals as well. They also got a lot of invertebrates in here, so if you're looking for some shrimp or some little crabs, they definitely got a lot. And these clownfish right here, look at these guys, just gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous fish. That's one thing I've always liked about saltwater, is the color of the fish. I mean, I know you can do a beautiful, colorful fish with cichlids, but man, the saltwater fish are just incredible. So down here, we got some more corals and another beautiful clownfish. So I'm not sure the name. I know there's the black and white clownfish are often referred to as maroon clownfish, possibly, but once again, not 100% sure. So pretty good selection of corals, I would say, to choose from. Pretty big variety. So let's go ahead and move on down here. This is kind of the back wall of the saltwater portion of the store, and you can see they got a good selection of saltwater fish. Some aggressive, some semi-aggressive, I guess, and some community. Pretty much just same thing with the freshwater as well. They got a red flame angel back there. That's my favorite fish in the saltwater hobby. The red flame has been my favorite since I first saw it when I was a kid. Geez, back in I think early 2000, I saw one of those in a tropical fish store, and it blew me away. The color of the red flames are just amazing. One of my favorite fish. So more saltwater fish over here. They got a lot of unique ones I'm seeing as well. Like this guy right here. It's pretty cool. Pretty cool looking. Check that guy out. Awesome fish. Up here, they got a puffer fish and some angels, and pretty good selection, I would say. Over here, we got some, I think I know the names of these guys. Haniokus, I'm pretty sure. I hope I got that right. But these are really popular saltwater fish. I've seen these in a lot of tanks on YouTube. And, you know, I can imagine why. They're gorgeous. You know, that high fin looks pretty interesting. And they got some more unique angels in the back, so pretty good selection so far. Let's keep on moving down. Got some more saltwater fish over here. Prices obviously for saltwater fish are a little bit more expensive, so if you're trying to get into saltwater for the first time, you definitely have to have you know, some cash, because it is a reasonable investment. So I mean, I'm seeing some fish that are priced that, you know, $40, $50, and to me they look like normal, you know, average, you know, community fish, but obviously they're not. They're speciality fish or rare fish or whatever. But yeah, you know, many different prices, but obviously a little higher than freshwater fish, but obviously be for good reason, because they're different, you know. Saltwater hobby is just, it's just more expensive. So clownfish in here, and some more saltwater fish down here. Beautiful fish. I would say they have a pretty good selection. I mean, if you're looking to fill your tank with lots of different colorful saltwater fish, they have a pretty good selection to choose from. I mean, some prices are expensive, but from what I'm seeing, there are fish that are relatively cheap, like, you know, $7 for some fish, you know. Obviously, they're not going to be the best, you know, most colorful or most unique, but still saltwater fish nonetheless, and a colorful saltwater fish. So you can pretty much still make it affordable, you know, getting into saltwater. So more saltwater fish down here. I think that's called some type of fox fish, fox face or something. Once again, not too familiar with the names, but really, really pretty fish. I love saltwater fish because there's so many different colors. They got some big fish down here. Really, really big fish. Oh my gosh. And this guy, I believe his name is pretty long. There's some, I think he's a Hawaiian fish, and they named him after something, but I remember watching or seeing this fish on the show Tanked, and one of the guys pronounced the name, and it was just like an incredibly long name. So that's pretty cool though. So as we work our way down, more saltwater fish. We got a lionfish in the back. Of course, lionfish are considered an invasive species in Florida, and in other some parts of the country as well, because they do just breed pretty rapidly, I guess. But still, I mean, awesome fish, you know. I think it would make a great addition to a saltwater tank, but poisonous, so something you definitely don't want to touch. Up here we got some more saltwater fish. Colors look vibrant, you know, they look healthy. I haven't really seen any fish with any visible health issues. I mean, of course, not every, you know, issue in an aquarium, as we discussed earlier with Kurt in the interview that I did with him, not every issue in a saltwater tank is visible, but nonetheless, as far as parasites or any issues with the fish, I'm not seeing that here. So fish look very, very healthy. So if you're coming down to Tropical Imports, you can definitely acquire some healthy stock for your tank. So as we move down here in the last couple tanks, we got some more saltwater fish, red flames. I can spot the red flames from a mile away, guys. It's my favorite fish. And it's so cute, it's so tiny. Look at that, oh my gosh. Such a cool fish. So down here, it seems like we got an aggressive fish. He's all by himself. Just some more average saltwater fish, clownfish up there. We got some dories, like, you know, Dory's Nemo. Dory and Nemo, look at them together, playing together. I hear that all the time when people come into tropical fish stores to buy fish, and they're not too experienced, you know, all they know is Nemo and Dory. So definitely that movie did help out with the saltwater hobby, I'm pretty sure, because they're selling a lot of Nemos and Dories now. So we'll move over here to show you guys this center island in the saltwater room here. They got some live rock here, I'm pretty sure, or coral. I mean, I'm not really 100% sure. As I said, guys, I'm not too familiar with saltwater, but I'm sure you guys can help me out in the comments here. But nonetheless, live rock, live something for your tank to start your tank with and put your corals on to attach to the rocks and get established. Pretty good selection. Up here, we got some starfish, and I can recognize these guys. These are chocolate chip stars, so pretty cool. I think they got a sea apple in there too. I don't think it's exposed right now, but I remember that from when I used to work at a fish store. We had one of those at the store, and it was a pretty cool looking thing. So we got some more shrimp down here. I think these are cleaner shrimp, so a good addition for your cleaner crew, you know, in your tank. They got some pretty unique starfish in the back. I haven't really seen one of those before. They call that a serpent star, I guess. $24.99 for that one. So really, really beautiful. Got the sea urchin in the back here. So pretty good selection of unique saltwater stuff, I would say. If you're definitely looking to acquire some unique specimens, they have a pretty good selection here. So that is pretty much the saltwater room. So before we head out into the main part of the store where they have a lot of their dry goods available, I wanted to show you guys the filtration system for the saltwater room, because it is pretty big and it is pretty, you know, it's pretty intricate. It's not a filtration system you see every day, of course, and definitely not one that the average home hobbyist has. So let's go take a look at the filtration system for the saltwater room. All right, so this is the filtration room for the saltwater portion of the store here at Tropical Imports. As you can see, it's kind of loud here. That's pretty much typical of most filtration rooms. You know, it's very loud, lots of motors going and, you know, things moving around. Kurt basically gave me a general overview of how everything works. So I'm pretty sure, if I remember correctly, he said that this is a bile ball chamber. So there are bile balls filled in here, and water is raining over these bile balls. And I mean, to me, since I've had a wet dry filter, I know that bile balls are good at collecting beneficial bacteria. So obviously that's collected a lot of beneficial bacteria over the years and made the tanks, you know, really healthy. Of course, it helps with the stability of the water as well. So really, really massive tower of bio balls. Now, as we move over here, we got a protein skimmer, which, you know, skims the tank for, you know, leftover proteins, all the waste, you know, helps remove excess nutrients, I'm pretty sure. So pretty big protein skimmer over here. Actually, it goes down in, the water goes down into a sump down in here as well that has live rock in it. So pretty cool. And then over here is a UV sterilizer. So this UV sterilizer has four large bulbs in here. And I mean, I have a UV sterilizer at home, and mine just has one bulb that's literally like this big. So seeing this thing, this is a huge industrial UV sterilizer. So this definitely helps keep the water clear, helps remove, you know, some of the bad stuff. I mean, I wouldn't say all parasites or, you know, bad things for the fish, but it definitely helps. You know, UV sterilizer is definitely a good investment no matter what. But yeah, it's four large bulbs. That's crazy, you know. And you can see the plumbing work is just all extravagant. And also, something I forgot to show you guys, the system also goes into a filter sock down here. I believe this is a 200 micron filter sock, and that helps remove some of the fine debris and particles. So that's why the tanks in the saltwater room are so vibrant and so clear. The micron socks just do an excellent job of filtering out those small particles. So and then we got some pumps over here. Rather large pumps, moving a lot of water. They look like a walkies, I think, the Japanese versions of the pumps. I'm pretty sure. They might be something different, but they do look like a walkies. But yeah, that's basically the filtration room for the saltwater portion of the store. So now that we've seen all the fish and the saltwater fish, the freshwater fish, the filtration, let's now go check out the Tropical Import selection of dry goods. Okay, so now we're in, I guess, the main part of the store. This is where Tropical Imports has all of their dry goods available. So we'll start over here. You can see they have some filtration system, power filters up here, some canister filters, all reasonably priced, really good prices. They have some decorations as well. So if you're one of those that likes to keep a lot of decorations in your tank or have a theme to your aquarium, they definitely got a lot of different decorations to choose from. Look at this one. This is pretty cool. They got a Buddha here. You can create a nice Zen type tank, or, you know, Asian themed tank, I guess. Lots of substrate at the bottom. Regular gravel, of course. So if you're doing just a normal freshwater tank and you want to put some gravel in to hold some beneficial bacteria, you know, have some substrate for your freshwater tank, they got that. Live sand over here. limestone over here for your saltwater tank, some fake corals, lava rock as well. Lava rock's really good for plants. Plants can attach fairly easily to lava rock. And they got holes in them too, so good for cichlids too. Cichlids to hide and make a little house in, I guess. They got some more up here. These rocks are rather sharp too, so be careful when you touch these. I'm not sure the name of this rock, but it is very sharp. So you can definitely cut yourself if you move your hand across it too hard. So, and once again, they got a lot of theme decorations. Look at this one up here. This is really, really cool. They got a Pirates of the Caribbean Dead Man's Chest decoration here, and Davy Jones is fighting Jack Sparrow in this decoration, and just really cool. I mean, I'm not really too into themed tanks, but if I did, that's probably a decoration I would choose. I mean, it's just fitting with fish tanks, you know, having something like that from the movie in your tank. So really, really cool. They got some fake plants down here. So fake plants to choose from. If you're not into having live plants, you can definitely just do fake plants and pretty much still have a nice looking tank to resemble, you know, a real planet tank. Looks like this one is a model after Jungle Val. And I would say it looks very similar as well. So pretty realistic fake plants. Down here is more of what I'm familiar with, and that is driftwood, planet tank substrate, and all that jazz. So they got, one thing I noticed is they got the driftwood here that's the kind of like the spider driftwood that you can use to create underwater trees and stuff. So, I mean, if I look through these pieces just really quickly here, oops, actually, you know what? That one looks good too. This one actually, you can create a nice kind of old looking tree, something that looks like it's been in your tank for a long time. Can tie some moss to that and let it grow out, and it'll look really, really realistic. Really, really realistic. So a really good selection of spider driftwood. So if you like to do some of that type of aquascaping, they definitely got that. They got EcoComplete here, which is a substrate that I used in my tank for like 3 years. It's a really great substrate. I don't see a price on here though, so I can't tell you guys how much it is. Oh, actually, I can. Here's the price right here. Oh, well, this is a different type of substrate, but $30 for a bag. That's pretty much the average price that they go for, so not too expensive. So they got planet tank substrates. If you're starting a planet tank, they definitely have that here. As I said, driftwood down here. This is kind of more like the Malaysian driftwood, so kind of like more the big driftwood, not the spider-looking thin piece of driftwood. So pretty cool. You can do a lot of buy a lot of supplies to make a nice planet tank. Okay, so as we move down here, you'll see that they also have some lizards, turtles. In other words, they got some reptiles. So they're not just limited to fish. They got some bearded dragons up there that are gorgeous. Pretty big guys too, kind of scary looking to me. And just lots of little hermit crabs and geckos. And so if you're looking to get some reptiles as well, they definitely have reptiles here. And I would say a pretty good selection to choose from. They got some frogs in there. They call these green Pac-Man frogs, $30 for that. Pretty cool. And then at the bottom here, below all the reptiles, you see they have a lot of rock. So if you're doing a cichlid tank, these rocks are pretty good for a cichlid tank. Over here, they got some baby bearded dragons, some small little bearded dragons over there. And then a turtle up here, a Russian tortoise, I guess. Actually, this is a Russian tortoise over here. So, pretty cool. So they do got reptiles as well. So, okay, let's go into the middle aisle here, which I would say is more for, aquarium stuff too, but on this side you'll see they have a lot of supplies for reptiles. They have dishes for water, for snakes, houses for snakes to hide in, substrate, food, things to clean the tank, the environment that the reptile's in. They got moss and stuff down here, so lots of good supplies, a good selection of food to choose from. So definitely if you're into reptiles or you have a reptile, They definitely got lots of supplies here to suit to your needs for your reptile at home. So down here, we got heaters for fish tanks. Hydro heaters are really great. I've used one of these before. They're kind of on the pricier side, but they are definitely quality. So if you are buying one of these, you're definitely paying attention to quality, and the price justifies that. They're very well made. They come from Italy, I believe. I actually own a Hydor canister filter, so really great quality stuff. Thermometers down here, they got some nets that you can use to catch your fish or remove leaves and stuff from your tank. Bubble wands, airline tubing, LEDs, stuff. They got some stuff for planted tanks like tweezers and scissors here. These scissors are actually really good for trimming carpets of dwarf baby tears or any type of carpeting plant, actually. So pretty cool. They got some rather unique stuff that you don't find in tropical fish stores, like this. This is a device used to skim the surface of your water in your aquarium to remove all that nasty surface film that develops, and you can connect this to a canister filter. And I've actually used one of these before I switched over to my Eheim 350 skimmer, and it works okay, I would guess, but you normally don't see stuff like that at a tropical fish store. You're mostly seen online, but they have it here at Tropical Imports, so definitely if you need something like that, come check it out. They got stuff to clean the glass or acrylic. Of course, make sure that you buy the appropriate cleaning pad if you have an acrylic tank, because you definitely don't want to scratch it. And they got some gravel vacuums, rather large gravel vacuums. If you have a big tank, a big cichlid tank, and that gets really dirty, you can clean your gravel really well. So a pretty good selection of dry goods for reptiles and fish. We'll go ahead and move on over here. And this seems to be where they have all their filtration media, medications, and as well as food for the aquarium hobby. So we got some bio bag filters here. Of course, this is for the Tetra Whisper series of power filters, a very, very popular line of filters from Tetra. I personally used a Tetra Whisper in one of my tanks for years. Very reliable, not so much on the biological side, because there isn't a way to put biological media in one of those filters, but nonetheless a good beginner filter, and they have definitely a lot of different sizes to choose from, so pretty much any size of power filter. Got some bio wheels for the Marineland penguin power filters, some micron socks as well, and some filter pads down here that you can cut to size. So if you have a canister filter or a wet dry filter or even a power filter, you can do the same thing with power filter. You can cut your own filter pads to size and not have to buy the pre-made ones, which could probably save you some money as well. I mean, you know, cutting filter pads to size to suit your needs kind of does save you money, because you're not using a lot of it, and you can still keep some for next time. So you can have a lot to last you. So got some more micron pads up here, lots of different filtration supplies. Down here is lots of filtration media, carbon, bio rings, which I'm probably going to pick up some of these because I need this for one of my canister filters. So I'm currently using bio balls right now, so I need some of these. I'll probably get some of these. These are ceramic rings. They're really great at collecting beneficial bacteria, so pretty cool. They got some rather unique filtration media as well. This is peat granules, so not sure what you would use that for. I never used that before, so you guys can let me know in the comments if you know. They got lots of other stuff like aquarium salt, activated carbon, lots of additives for a saltwater tank, potassium, lots of different brand names, calcium, iodine, lots of different stuff. So a pretty good selection of supplies. Of course, all the normal stuff for a freshwater tank. They got, stuff to help with algae, easy balance, water conditioners, all really good prices as well. And also they got stuff for planted tanks, which is important because the planted tank hobby is really taken off here in America. It's been popular over in Europe for a number of years, but it seems like more people are getting into the planet tank hobby here in the United States. So they got the Flourish line of nutrients, which is what I use. I love the Flourish line of nutrients. I use iron, potassium, phosphorus, nitrogen, all that stuff. Even Flourish Trace is good. Adds trace elements to your aquarium. All reasonably priced. So they definitely got supplies for planet tanks as well. So we moved down here towards the end of the dry goods section of the store, and you see that they have cichlid food up here. They got flake food down here for fresh and saltwater fish. I actually use this flake food. I have for years, the Tetra color flakes. I've used that for, oh my gosh, like it seems like all my life. That's all I've used is the Tetra flakes. But when Tetra came out with the Tetra color, that's what I switched to, and my fish love it. They go crazy. If you watch some of my previous videos, you actually see that when I put the can of food in front of the tank, the fish will actually follow it. They love this food, you know. So that's pretty much it for the dry good selection of tropical imports. Actually, let me show you guys. They got some small tanks here. Actually, these are really cool. Look at these. Then they got some fluval specs. I never actually heard of these before. So create a nice, really small planet tank, a little nano system, I guess, if you're limited on space. And do a cute little planet tank. I got, oh, this is pretty. This is a glass tank with curved edges. That's rare or unique, I should say. Definitely something that's traditional with acrylic aquariums, not so much with glass tanks, but definitely they have curved glass here, and actually it's just gorgeous. This would make a beautiful planet tank. I love the rimless design. You know, there's nothing obstructing the top. It just looks so cool. So a pretty good selection of small tanks. They got a little hexagon tank up here. That's pretty neat. And then another little small nano tank over here, and a fluval chi. that's cute. That's so tiny. You can definitely do some little miniature aquascapes. So all right, guys, that looks like that's about it. That is the dry good portion of tropical imports. All right, guys, so that is it. That is the store tour of tropical imports here in Glendale, California. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I really appreciate it. If you guys would like to see me do more of these tropical fish stores, which I would really love to, you know, they're so much fun. They're so unique. You hear so many different stories from the owners, you know, how they started in the business and stuff. If you'd like to see me do more of these tropical fish stores, definitely help me out on Patreon by giving me a monthly contribution. When you do that, it helps me pay for all the expenses that it takes to do these videos. I mean, today we traveled, round trip, we're going to travel 160 miles just to do this video for you guys. So it's a lot of work doing these videos, and I would appreciate if you guys would support my channel on Patreon. Patreon's a great site. It's very reliable, and you know, you can do a monthly contribution, I believe, and I believe the minimum pledge is like $1. So, I mean, it's not much. So, you know, it just lets me know that you guys appreciate what I do, and you know, it helps me do more on this channel. So thanks again for watching, guys. I really appreciate it. I'll leave the address to tropical imports here on the screen, so definitely come check them out. They're a great store. They have lots to offer, lots of saltwater fish, lots of freshwater fish, stuff for planet tanks especially. I know you guys are into planet tanks, so lots to choose from there. So thanks again for watching, guys. I really appreciate it. And I'll see you next time on another tropical fish store tour here on Jacob's Aquarium. Have fun with your tanks, everybody. And I'll see you next time.